Basic vacuum tube curve tracer. This video is part of a hobby project with the hope that it could provide useful information. If you see or hear something horribly wrong in what I do, it might be helpful if you took the time to let me know. This video is part of the introductory chapter describing some minimal equipment, starting from an insulation transformer and a dim bulb tester. This video only shows how a basic vacuum tube curve tracer could be built. For more details about the content of this video, please see the original written documentation. The basic vacuum tube tracer described here is meant to associate the voltage applied to the control grid of a tube to the current flowing from the plate to the cathode. Therefore, the tube would be tested working only with the function of a simple triode. In practice, a sawtooth signal is applied between the grid and the cathode, reading the resulting voltage across a cathode resistor. Knowing the value of the cathode resistor, the current passing through can be easily calculated. This is the basic schematics of the tube tracer. The sawtooth signal would be applied to the grid using a capacitor, while the average voltage would be controlled by an external power supply. This power supply should be fully isolated from the circuit ground and from any external ground, so that it can be connected between cathode and grid without consequences. Ideally, the oscilloscope should be connected directly, but a capacitor could be inserted as well to protect the scope, although that would increase the amount of noise that would appear on the screen. Another thing to consider is that all the grounds must have the same potential. In other words, the curve tracer, the function generator, and the oscilloscope should be on the same ground, otherwise they might be damaged. Here are the component values that have been used. Please notice that the cathode resistor could have a different value depending on the expected current that has to be measured. As an example, the triode section of a 12VT6 is to be tested. The original documentation of this tube shows that for a plate voltage of 100 volts, the typical grid voltage configuration should be of minus 1 volt, while the plate current would not exceed 1 milliamp. There is also a graph showing that for the same plate voltage, if, for a very short period of time, the grid voltage reaches zero or becomes slightly positive, the plate current would not be excessively high. The plan is to apply to the grid of this tube a sawtooth signal of 5 volts peak to peak, oscillating between minus 4.5 and 0.5 volts, therefore with an average voltage of minus 2 volts. Here is the corresponding practical circuit. The frequency of the sawtooth signal has been set to 1 kHz. Here is what the oscilloscope might show. Unfortunately, in reality, also a lot of noise is represented by the oscilloscope, at least on an analog oscilloscope. The visual noise becomes less annoying. To give meaning to what is read on the oscilloscope, the horizontal space separating one peak from the next should be ideally divided into the various voltage levels that the sawtooth signal applied to the tube grid can have. If the vertical axis of the oscilloscope is calibrated, The corresponding voltage reading can be divided by the value of the cathode resistor to obtain the corresponding current. As it is relatively easy to build this type of curve tracer for a single tube, if a dual trace oscilloscope is available, duplicating the circuit to match tubes would be the obvious next step. What is necessary is to make sure that the applied sawtooth signal is the same for both tubes. It could be the same signal duplicated to both inputs, or if there is a concern that a bad tube could influence the signal received by the other, it could be an identical and synchronous one generated separately. On the oscilloscope screen, it could be sufficient to overlap the two curves to evaluate the differences. And if safety conditions are preserved, the tubes could also be unplugged and plugged on the fly to find the perfect matching pair. For various reasons, it might be judged more appropriate to align the ground to the cathode of the tube under test. This would be probably okay, but the curve appearing on the oscilloscope screen would be flipped vertically. In the written documentation mentioned at the beginning of this video, there is the description of a project defined there as the power chest. That was meant to be an all-in-one piece of equipment, including the function of an insulation transformer, dim bulb test, capacitor tester, and vacuum tube tester. Originally, the tube tester section was meant to be used for collecting data in a table, filled manually, that with the help of a spreadsheet software would generate tube curves. With the last amendments, the function of the basic tube curve tracer described here has been included, renouncing the dangerous capacitor tester and other little functionalities that proved to be useless, and the full written documentation is available. It is not recommended to replicate the project of the power chest in full because there may be very serious problems with the ground connection of the BNC sockets, potentially conflicting with the ground used on a radio under test, connected to the insulation transformer and dim bulb. Please read the documentation if you are interested. However, what might be more generally interesting is the matrix of switches used to configure the connection of a tube that is to be tested. Again, if you are interested, please read the written documentation. And if you have questions, feel free to write an email to my address. If you would like to contribute to this project, donating old electronics, old equipment, or old radios in whatever condition they might be, that could be helpful for my next restoration documentation.